Hi, Teresa. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to first introduce ourselves. I'm Anna Strong. I'm the program coordinator at Catherine Health Center, and this is my friend, Teresa.
Hi, I'm Teresa Diduch. I've been with the Wise Women Program and with Catherine's Health Center for several years now.
Sure. Well, again, thank you for joining me today just to share your story. And I'm going to be going over a couple questions with you. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to start by taking us back a little bit. Once you described yourself as a Gerber baby,
mm-hmm.
can you share mm-hmm. a little bit about where you're from and what your family's like and what you were like as a kid? What's your backstory?
Okay. I was born at Gerber Memorial Hospital in Fremont. And I was not the Gerber baby, but a Gerber baby. My parents owned a farm,
mm-hmm.
and they also had off-farm jobs. Mom was a teacher, Dad was a construction laborer, and they did not take usual vacations. The vacations were, how fast can the station wagon go on the
sure.
glacial terrain of Oceana County? And this was before seat belts.
Mm.
We got them later. Had two older brothers, still do. Married into Grand Rapids. I had the bank account, he had the house. Let's see, back to the folks again. Very self-sufficient.
Being on the farm.
Right.
Mm-hmm. What was that like growing up on a farm for you? And how has that impacted your health or your health journey over time?
I'm thinking that there was a lot of responsibility for what we put into our mouths.
Mm.
There was... When I was little, DDT had been out for
sure.
a while, and I think there were some questions with Rachel Carson, I think, the author that did the Silent Spring book, and the consequences of what we eat affecting how we live. Dad developed adult onset diabetes, and my mom's challenge was how to keep him healthy.
So adapting to that new diagnosis with the awareness of how important food is.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And you have the food is love thing
mm-hmm.
component.
Mm-hmm.
His idea of the marriage contract was it also included a blueberry pie a week. And she did her due diligence on getting it down to a quarter cup
mm-hmm.
and choosing the best berries available and using Jell-O and an open-faced rather than a two-crust pie.
Mm-hmm.
And Dad died with all his fingers and toes. So there were some times when his circulation was to the point of looking purple in the winter.
Mm-hmm. And how has that impacted you in your own personal journey for health?
I recognize sugar binges.
Mm-hmm.
I recognize that if I want to live to be a ripe old age,
mm-hmm.
and knowing that in the family tree there are strokes, there are heart situations, plus diabetes coming from both parents,
mm-hmm.
don't want to go there.
Sure.
That is very complicated, and it'll attack every system you got.
So doing what you can to prevent that from happening and staying healthy.
Right.
So share with me, you said that marriage brought you to Grand Rapids.
Mm-hmm.
How did you learn about Catherine's Health Center?
My family have been part of St. Alphonsus.
Okay.
And when the, let's see, Catherine started out in the basement of the church.
So you're from the basement time behind the blue door.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Blue door's still gorgeous. And the, what'd you do now, Anna? Sirens. So, we'll wait a minute. There was the time of being in between insurances and then being without insurance.
And what was that time like for you?
Thankful very much that Catherine's was here for us.
Sure.
Dr. Whalen, as far as I know, had donated like half of his work week to serve here. And I met the nurse practitioner, Dr. Bosenbrook?
Deborah Bosenbrook?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
And just call her Deb. She's
wonderful.
She's awesome. And I've been working with her more than anybody else on staff. Mm. One time had a social worker meeting. In my history, there was a period of time back when I had insurance work related that I spent a week at Pine Rest and had the follow up with a counselor through them, and then got to the point where to be self governing and self monitoring. And my husband and kids pretty much would be aware of, well, mom's in her slow mood or mom's in her go-go mood. And basically, when the sun's out and we've got spring, yes, it's go-go mood.
Just lifts your mood.
Exactly.
Sure.
And
but being a part of that really helped build some of your self-awareness to identify kind of where you're at and how to cope through different things.
Right. And and not only watching the carbs and the sugar and the fried food, watching the weight.
Because I know you like to walk your dog quite a lot.
Right.
Sure, that you're very active.
And could be more active, but this is what we got in the warmer weathers here now. There are more opportunities to do things.
So you first came to Catherine's through St. Alphonsus when we were behind the blue door in the basement there.
Right.
And you've stayed with Catherine's this entire time, working with Dr. Deb, Deb Bosenbrook. And one of the things that Catherine's really focuses on is engaging patients as active participants in their care and just meeting folks where they're at. And it sounds like you've been very engaged with a lot of different programs through Catherine's. And one of the things is working with Calvin nursing students as a neighborhood health advocate. How has Catherine's helped support you in taking on that role to support community health where you live?
Right. I did that on a formal basis as a Calvin employee several years ago.
Sure.
Thought about doing it this year, and I go, just chill a little bit.
Give yourself some time.
Right. And being the bridge, introducing the nursing students to the neighbors, and then sometimes follow-up, because some people had very complicated situations. They needed a dentist, or they needed more health counseling on a certain topic. And one family I remember was multi-generational. I think there was great-grandma, grandma, daughter, and grandchildren. So there were a lot of needs to mingle in there, all within one household. And to get that need clarified and then come back with the answers the next time if you didn't have it all in your tackle box.
Sure.
Your toolkit. So it's not only having answers, but knowing where to go when it's not a quick fix.
Right.
So
Can you share some of the programs that you have been involved in at Catherine's Health Center?
Mm-hmm.
And just speak to, you know, a program that is close to your heart that you've been involved in. What's the experience been like for you?
There's like a triumvirate here, at least. The Wise Woman Gardening Program has been incredible.
Can you share a little bit about Wise Woman Gardening and what you've done with the program?
For 2 years, the Centers for Disease Control had given us a boost, and thank you to the taxpayers to have that allotment. We got together for spring conferences statewide, mm-hmm. and toured different locations. The first year I attended, there was a hospital with a farm across the street. So they took the peelings and trimmings from the kitchen and supported the worm pit that was at the farm. They put the peelings in there, and they've discerned that red wigglers were the most efficient
for doing the vermicompost.
Thank you.
Sure.
And then we got samples of them. We made a worm box through Catherine's and with the Kent Recycling. We learned about how to garden in different ways. We've been to Grand Valley, we've been to Battle Creek, we've been to individual plots, and we've worked with the community garden across the street behind the old convent.
So you've got a plot back behind Carrier Street there at the Crescent Neighborhood Association, and you've been in that plot for some time. What are some things that you're growing there, and has your time on the farm, you know, growing up in Fremont, you know, intrigued you to participate in our gardening program?
Yes. And last year I was not the star student. I've been growing kale for several years, and this year it was not up to par. So we'll see what happens. There are different kinds, and I think that there are certain kinds that overwinter better than others. So I saw a stalk or two in another plot that were beautiful. And then the ones that were like the dinosaur, big, enormous, tall, like chest high. And they're like, okay, we're brown. Why is that? well, they've been wintered outside. And we've been taught about hoop houses and extending the growing season. And I'd like to get into that a little bit more.
Okay.
Because we are prone to have funny kinds of weather.
Sure, yep, especially living in Michigan. You never know what the weather is going to do.
Right, and if we can eke a few more warm days out of it, I'd like to try it. I've thought about a cold frame, but I haven't put that into action yet. I've got the raw sketches for it.
And do you find that being a part of the gardening program, you're more connected to community? And in what ways?
It's nice to see a mixture of ages. And I think Wise Women is like, what, 48 to 64 years of age?
40 to 64, yep.
For the window. And sometimes we age out of the program, but we're still welcome. The energy involved. The one tour we did of two neighboring gardens out in, I think it was Ottawa County?
Last year?
Yes.
In the Walker area?
Oh, okay. It was out of Grand Rapids, though.
Tammy's garden.
Yes. Yep. And her neighbor.
And her neighbor.
With the wood chips. And the lovely setup with the water service there was pretty impressive. How to outsmart the wild animals, either the deer with the white shirts on, coat
kind of
hangers,
like a, sure,
and moving those locations periodically.
So you've learned a lot of different techniques that you can incorporate that is exciting to you. But it sounds like with some of the tours and, you know, events that you've attended, that has really brought a greater sense of community along with that diversity of age. Like you said, there's so much energy within the program. Kind of sidestepping just a little bit, you know, in talking about Catherine's Health Center and when you were in between from having insurance and not having insurance and working with Deb Bossenbrook, what is the feeling, or is there a word that comes to mind when you think of Catherine's? What would you tell somebody in the community about Catherine's?
Positive nurturing.
And tell me a little bit about that.
Making the most of where you are and what you have. And you don't always have to worry about transportation, because there are certain things with the way the program is set up and with child care. The only one I went to, unfortunately, for gardening over the winter, there was a young fella there who was in the classroom with us, or conference room, and he was a wheelchair user. And that way she didn't have to get a caregiver. He was right in there with us.
Sure. So being adaptable to you know, individuals' needs.
And we have a bus stop within a few feet of the building,
which makes access, you know, somewhat convenient if you're taking the bus line and need support. So you would describe Catherine's as really compassionate, and I heard positivity is something that you mentioned. Can you speak to the positivity piece and how you view or see Catherine's?
Right. When you have a situation where you should be taking your medication every day, are you taking your medication every day? And what's the reaction if you don't? What is the reaction, or what's the most important thing when you come in for your appointment? One time I came in and I had apparently crossed paths with a brown recluse spider the previous weekend. And it was to the point of almost non-weight-bearing and not putting a... There was a lot of swelling on our ankle.
Just discomfort, sure.
And zoom, I had three prescriptions. Plus, how you doing otherwise, but this is what we need to take care of, because it can destroy tissue if you do not attend to this properly.
So not only getting your cares, you know, your needs met, but having somebody checking in with you. Just assessing overall what else can we do for you. So feeling like you have a partner or somebody to go to whenever, you know, something's going on, or you need to be seen and get in. Sure.
And pairing up with other people. Some people maybe had their grandchildren that period of time, so they were welcome along. Some people didn't have transportation from another part of the city, so we did some carpooling. Just socialization periodically. You know? You
walk in. More than a doctor's office.
You walk in there, and many times there's bread. Like, if you need bread that you don't have to pay $3 or $4 for going out the door, you're welcome to do that. There are resources. Like, if you don't have a dentist yet, these are some choices you can do. There was 6 hours within 1 month when I had a change in income. And then somehow I need to logically work to Medicare if I chose to go that route, because I'm not in the usual workday world with a employer covered insurance.
And you've met with the insurance navigator to kind of navigate and support that process?
Right.
And what was your experience working with the navigator at Catherine's?
It was very civilized.
Okay. That's good to hear.
It was amazingly long. You figure an hour and a half or so.
Sounds like you may have had a complicated situation with your insurance.
I don't know if I made it complicated or if the situation was just complicated.
Sure.
And who has the crystal ball to know what all the insurance needs are going to be?
Mm-hmm.
And to make the right choice, the right plan. So,
did you feel like coming out of that you were supported to, you know, have what you were looking for and your needs met at that time?
Right. The places to go for the next step. When to plan in for the switch over to, hang in there. We are drama mamas, aren't we?
I don't know what's happening out there today.
Okay.
With the sirens.
Right. So, getting coverage at the right time and knowing that it's affordable and using the willpower to do the right thing so it will continue to be affordable. Because if I do the don't care, don't whatever, we can look at heart attacks, we can look at stroke. Those are not cheap diagnoses.
So making sure that you have some kind of coverage and a plan and a team that you're working with so you can prevent, you know, all of those things that you saw your dad go through with his diabetes and, you know, bringing that component of the gardening in and eating healthy just to, you know, support your well-being over time. What makes Catherine's different than other places? Why not go somewhere else? Why Catherine's?
This is very local.
Okay.
Very cozy. You pretty much know everybody on staff once you've been going here a while. There's a lot of good energy in the staff. There was, let's see, we talked about the gardening program. There is another program with medical professionals, women doctors. And it was an evening program where we got together and cooked. And this is how much the meal would cost. Cooking Matters has been offered.
Yeah, sure. So you did Cooking Matters?
Not through this group, but through the previous group at another location.
Okay.
So.
But good energy.
Right.
That you feel like you are a part of Catherine's. That's one of the things that I love being at Catherine's, is that when somebody walks in that door, it's you're part of a family. And you might be, you know, meeting with your provider We've got behavioral health that is integrated with the services that we provide, but also mm-hmm. health coaching through the Wise Woman program mm-hmm. and gardening. There's so mm-hmm. many different extensions and facets of what we do that gives us, you know, a foot in the clinic, but also in the community. Mm-hmm. And we bring, you know, again, patients as participants in their care, and we are actively engaged in kind of working together mm-hmm. to meet the needs of our patient population and individuals, you know, like you, speaking to your story in your involvement with Catherine's.
And the parish community with the young at heart.
Uh-huh, sure.
Through St. Alphonsus, there are different programs there. And one thing that is coming up so often in the literature, or even in, if you're watching the morning news, like Kathy Lee Gifford was talking about the loneliness after her husband and her mother died.
Sure. And
she's turning another page in that she's not going to be doing the morning programs anymore. She's backing away from that. And when my husband died, it was a different niche too.
Yeah.
So when you think somebody that's been with you for 35 years and then all of a sudden they aren't, but you have to think like they did mm-hmm. for whatever. Mm-hmm. If I don't have the answers, I know people I can trust to steer me in that direction.
Mm-hmm. That we're here for you.
Right.
So you have that sense of security that you're not in this alone, no matter what you're going through. Mm-hmm. And I know I had seen you the day after that had happened, mm-hmm. and you came in for a vermicompost workshop here. Teresa was the only one who came. And we had so much fun doing that, but it was, you know, in that time of grieving where mm-hmm. things were still so surreal,
mm-hmm.
You know, to show up for yourself and plug in and be mm-hmm. with others. Because
mm-hmm.
it's, you know, been a hard thing to navigate for you.
And it was something that, in retrospect, I would not have figured that it would happen in that time frame.
Mm-hmm.
And we all need a little bit of education in many ways. And you should see the books that are written about the human body, and then a whole nother set for the human brain and how to put them all together.
Yeah.
So
just kind of figuring things out as you go and move through life, mm-hmm. being your best self.
Mm-hmm.
And you've been doing wonderful. We're so appreciative to have you participate in our programs. I have so much enjoyed working with you, and, you know, your vivacious, energized, you know, compassionate self to come in, and you support the programs, not only participate mm-hmm. in the programs. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we are here because of you. So we mm-hmm. thank you, you know, for sharing your story and being a part of this.
Thank you
so much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate you coming in.
Glad to do it.